hit me.
It's my driveway, man. Why'd you pull into my driveway? What are you doing? Are you one of those goddamn insurance scammers?
No, ma'am. I am the... See, my name's Logan. Logan Ranger. See, it's like the Lone Ranger, except instead of fighting outlaws, I am the outlaw.
See, I've been at it for quite a few moons now, but highway robbery just isn't quite what it used to be. Seems to me that nowadays, lots of folks don't quite know how to treat the modern-day thief. See, they throw things at me, or they call me a bozo. I don't even know what that means. What it does mean is that sometimes I have to crack the whip, make them understand that there are greater forces at play. For whom the bell tolls, as the saying tolls, it tolls for them, because I may just be the angel of death they were hoping not to see.
What? No. Hey, man. No, I don't want any trouble.
Well, I do. That's...
What?
No, no, oh, I, no, no. Not with you. No, blast it. I didn't... Oh,
what
no,
are you
no,
talking
no,
about?
No, shoot. No.
What?
Oh, no, I didn't. I'm done. Oh,
what?
Oh, my. Huh. Blown it again. Oh, fuck.
Hey, bro. What you doing?
Howdy, partner. You wouldn't have to have a spare flashlight on you, would you?
Bro, what you doing? What's going on, man?
You already asked me that. But since you asked, I'll tell you. My name is Logan Ranger. And I know I'm just sitting here on this here grassy knoll, but I'm a highwayman by trade. See, I'm directing the light from this here transmitter telephone into the eyes of oncoming motorists in the hope that they may careen off the side of the road so that I could pillage their resources. Yeah. Now, if the declination of my radiation is true, I should be picking the pockets of corpses by sundown.
So, like, kind of like crime? Like crime? Crime?
Yeah, well, I reckon you'd have to fancy yourself a criminal to be committing a crime, and I just so happen to be an outlaw.
Do you want to say that again?
Oh, you fancy yourself too, huh?
You want to say that again? You're what?
So you're telling me your job is to threaten the lives of American motorists, which, in case you didn't know, is reckless endangerment?
My name is Logan Ranger, and I hope that they make green so that I could kill corpses by sundown.
As I have done and will continue to do, yeehaw. Hey,
now, I don't like what you're insinuating.
You totally forged that tape.
I edited it in the car right here.
I just don't know what to do with him.
Well, so put him under the jail.
Nah, he's harmless. But we can't let him back out just yet. He's difficult. He's not picking up when we're putting down. So what's your plan here, buddy?
Now listen, I'm just sitting here attempting to corroborate with you fellas.
Oh. Cut the crap.
Cut the crap.
Who are you?
As aforementioned, my name is Logan Ranger. It's like the Lone Ranger, except instead of fighting outlaws, I am the outlaw.
Logan, come on, we're trying to help you. Who are you, really?
Tell him, Tony.
Well, I'm me.
Is that really who you want to be?
What?
Hello. It's a new toll on this road, and I'm here to collect your capital.
On whose authority?
Why, that would be my own authority. See, I'm a highwayman, and I ride the highs of these ways in ways that leave me high and mighty rich.
Why?
Well, because
nobody tells you where to go, baby. What if I ride? What if you walk? What if you rock around the clock? Nobody tells you what to do, baby. Hey, hey, kid, shake a leg. Maybe you're crazy in the head, baby.
Then, as the music fades out, we see him walk through the field to a hay bale, sit down, and fall asleep against it, thus literally and metaphorically hitting the hay. I mean, the way I see it in this film, he's kind of coming to terms with his place in the world. I mean, he's wandering, he's realizing that the highway isn't really his home, not because it isn't an actual presence of a home, but because it represents the space in between. See, even though he thinks he wants this lifestyle of nomadic behavior, a sort of Kerouac, beatnik, traveler type of gig, what he's really missing is a place where he feels comfortable. He's moving towards detaching from his highwayman persona that he's used as this barrier between himself and reality. So touring these environments is a way of accepting that he just has to be, rather than be something. He ends up in the field coming to terms with this realization, understanding that it isn't black and white. He's only able to practice existing if he gives himself time to exist in space. The only way to take the pacifier away from the baby is to rip it out and let him cry. He's a highwayman, but not in the sense of a ha-ha highway robber, but literally a man of the highways, of those liminal traveling spaces, even if they aren't actual interstate highways. He's philosophizing in a very surface level way. He's skimming the dead bugs and pond scum off the top of the philosophy pool, I guess.
So you say this happened to a guy you know?
I was a highwayman. Along the coach roads I did ride, with sword and pistol by my side. Many a young maid lost her baubles to my trade. Many a soldier shed his lifeblood on my blade. The bastards hung me in the spring of 25, but I am still alive.